Hey guys, this is Dennis, the founder of Think Hero.
And I'm David Griffin, your resident comic book and video game guru.
And this is our review of the Lego Movie, which I just saw for the third time.
This is my first time seeing this. Heard so many good things. I had to check it out.
So, so what'd you think?
I liked it. It's good. It's a fun, you know, it's fun. It's just got a lot of comedy and great. It's all the things that I love about the Lego video games, you know, just kind of just riffs off of all these great, you know, pop culture tropes and just has fun with them. And it has like kind of a heartwarming story throughout the whole thing. It's good.
Yeah, it's fun, charming.
Yeah. It,
like you said, there's a heartwarming story. Kind of reminds, you know, Pixar kind of has that.
Right.
And yeah, it's just, I keep saying this, I've said this before and other things. I feel like, I know it's like a kid's movie, right? But it feels like it's really like, not so much like adult, but like, older, like maybe like teenager and above type of movie.
Oh yeah, for
sure. That's disguised as a kid's movie.
Yeah.
Because there's so many jokes and, you know, we'll go into a spoiler section later that I'll mention some of these things, but there's all these jokes that only people who are like older than like 13 would actually get.
Right, I mean, there's just a lot of little, again, just pop culture references, comic book things, famous movies, things that, you know, especially movies that are a little bit older,
yes,
that, you know, that young people probably haven't seen yet, or if they have, they might not get the references, stuff that people that, you know, upper 20s, mid-30s, and older are going to get, you know, which any great animated movie is going to do, you know, to some degree. They want to be able to entertain the parents, entertain the kids at the same time, which is tough. It's a tough balance to do.
Yeah, what I noticed with this is, like, there's things for the kids as well. Obviously, the great visuals.
Right.
It's basically, it's a 3D animated film.
Right.
But they make it look like a stop-motion film.
Yeah,
Which is popular on YouTube. They're called brick films. And it's, like, this whole, like, subculture of people that, like, do that as a hobby.
Right.
And so it has that look, but obviously it's like, super, super big-budgeted version of it. But even though it's like that, it's for, the kids will love all the visuals and they'll love like a lot of the physical humor and some of the stuff, but then and the adults will laugh at that too, but then there's this other layer of other jokes that for the kids just goes right over their head.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's funny. Everything hits right. I mean, just the humor and the way the characters move, their animation, everything about the movie is just funny. It's just really well done.
And really good voice actors.
Great. Yeah,
you know, Chris Pratt.
Yep, Will Arnett.
Yeah.
What's his name from Saturday Night Live? All those guys from Saturday Night Live. But
Will Ferrell. There's Nick Offerman,
For Elizabeth Banks.
Yeah, Elizabeth Banks.
Yeah.
Nick Offerman, but you can't really tell it's his voice.
No, he's like, yarr, he's like his pirate voice.
Alison Brie, you can't really tell her voice.
Liam Neeson, of course.
Yeah, Liam Neeson.
You can hear his voice right away, you recognize it.
And you get to see a lot of, you know, you see Channing Tatum as Superman, Kobe Smulders as Wonder Woman, Jonah Hill as Green Lantern.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's all all these really good actors, voice actors coming in. I thought it was a lot of funny. The pace is very fast.
It's good.
Very fast paced. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They don't really let up. And the jokes keep coming. So, I mean, overall, what are your, you know, overall impressions of it? And what kind of grade would you give it before we get into the spoiler section?
I give it an A as far as kids' movies go. Not kids, but just animated movies go. It's fun. It's entertaining. It's kind of the way you and I talked about how we feel about, I've seen Wreck-It Ralph, which I loved. And this is a movie I'll definitely buy when it comes out. I just enjoyed watching it, everything about it, the humor, the story. I'd give it an A. You know, I'm not saying it's the best animated movie I've ever seen, but I mean, I in terms of what it delivers, it definitely does a great job. So I'm giving it an A. Definitely must see.
Yeah, I'm going to give it an A-, and I think it's definitely a must-see, and I've already seen it 3 times. It's one of those movies you can see multiple times. There's a lot of, I think, like, visual gags that are going on everywhere. So you're going to see it again?
Yeah, I'll probably see it again. Yeah, definitely. Okay. Yeah, that's good.
Okay, so let's get into some spoiler stuff. So when I'm talking about adult stuff, there's, like, stuff that little kids aren't going to get, you know? Like, just little things, like the overpriced coffee, you know,
that'll
be $37.
Reference to Starbucks,
Like, you know, little kids aren't gonna, kids don't buy coffee, they don't drink coffee. Another thing was the voting machines owned by the president.
He's like, wait a minute. They wrote the history books.
Yeah.
He's like, wait a minute, like all that stuff,
There's
corruption, just, government corruption and all
there's
that.
A lot of those things like that kids aren't gonna get. I mean, just a lot of the Batman stuff, the relationship stuff.
That song he has.
The song he has, you have to be a fan of Batman to really get that.
It's about me being an orphan.
Yeah.
It's darkness.
Darkness.
No parents.
Yeah, that's good.
Super rich.
Right.
Makes it a little better. Yeah. That's the lyrics for the song.
It's good. It's really, really good.
You know, in the whole, like, wild style, are you a DJ?
Right,
you know,
yeah.
Like, you kind of have to be a little bit older to understand right. that type of joke.
But there's so much visual stuff going on in the background that kids are going to...
Yes.
They're going to love it. Yeah, they're going to love it.
Yeah. You know, they'll love, like, Unikitty and all this other stuff going on. And you know, one of my favorite parts, which I don't know if little or kids would get it because they'd have to know the lore.
Right.
Of Star Wars, the Star Wars cameo.
Oh yeah, especially when, I mean, Lando Calrissian is not, if you're a little kid, unless your parents have shown you Star Wars, you're not going to get that right away, I don't think. And just the humor of those guys going off to some, you know, big party.
Yes.
You know, on Naboo. I mean, it's just, it was just perfect. The guy, and then Batman comes back and says, all dudes. Just all dudes.
even the hairy one.
Yeah, even the hairy one was a dude.
It's metal one too. Like that humor is definitely for more, you know, teenage and above.
Right.
Like, yeah, like when you get older in relationships, sometimes you just want to just be able to go hang out with the guys or do something else.
And I really like the spaceship guy with the 80s, all the 80s sci-fi stuff, all like it was great. Yeah, just so many good little references, cultural references in there.
Yeah, and we got like comic book and like you had Channing Tatum as Superman and Jonah Hill as Green Lantern.
Which is, of course, 21 Jump Street.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because the directors, Phil Lord and Chris Miller, that directed the Lego movie, they directed 21 Jump Street.
Right.
They also directed Cloud Day with a Chance of Meatballs. So there's that connection. So, like, that's even funnier because it's not just, you know, Green Lantern trying to suck up and kiss up to Superman. It's Jonah Hill trying to suck up to Channing Tatum, co-stars.
you can just see it in the way, you can hear it in his voice, and you just know it's Jonah Hill. He's great.
Yeah, and then Liam Neeson as good cop, bad cop was pretty funny.
Doing two different voices, like his accent. He was good too. I mean, just so many good voice actors in this.
And what did you think of the whole kind of reveal and cut to the live action with Will Ferrell and the kid, I think his name's Finn in the movie.
Right.
How do you like that part of it? Because it kind of brought the heart
great.
To it.
Yeah, I thought it was great because, like you said, it brought a heart to it. It gave that kind of heartwarming story. It kind of brought it, because, I mean, this is Legos. They are Legos. I mean, Legos has branched off to this, you know, multi-million dollar, however much money they make, franchise where they do video games now. They're probably more known for their video game adaptation, you know, like Marvel, Indiana Jones, Harry Potter, video game adaptations than they are for, you know, buying Legos and actually building Legos. Mm-hmm. So, but like this movie kind of got to the heart of that. It's like, look, we have all this stuff, all these franchises that we market, but like it's about, you know, I guess you'd say a father and a son or a relationship with a kid and his dad.
Creativity.
You know, creativity. And like, look what all these people have built. Look what they've done. And it's not about being perfect and like following the rules and being exactly what the box. So I was a little kid. I hardly ever built Legos exactly like the box
told me to.
I didn't have the patience for it, first of all. I always just did whatever I wanted
to. Yeah, I would combine it with, like, I'd have one toy here, one here, and I would use parts from this one to this one and whatever. And
well, first, trying to understand his son's imagination.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Not only that, I was mixing, you know, like, it was the Transformers and the G.I. Joe and the He-Mans and the Legos. And then I took my sister's toys, like Strawberry Shortcake and My Little Pony, and they'd be like the prisoners.
Right, yeah.
They'd be the people that need to be rescued, you know.
So that kind of reminded me of Toy Story.
Yeah.
Yeah, you always see like the kid playing with Woody and, you know, a Tyrannosaur, or, you know, the dinosaur, and then playing with Buzz Lightyear. Doesn't make sense, but it's the kid's imagination, which, of course, at Will Ferrell's age, you might forget, you know.
Yeah. Oh, that reminds me, I was going to say, another joke, too, like the whole Michelangelo.
That was good.
Like,
only
older people would get that. Kids would be like, what? I don't understand.
Yeah, Michelangelo, yeah.
Like, Gandalf, no, or Dumbledore. No, I'm Gandalf. That's Dumbledore.
That was good.
Like, or Dumbledore or whatever.
Dumbledore, the Abraham Lincoln. Like, you come back here on your flying chair.
Yeah, so I just think there's just a lot of stuff in there. And I have found, having seen it three times, I found the kids love it. I think the adults love it even more than the kids.
Yeah, I heard there were kids in the audience, but I heard the adults cracking up more than the kids. Not that that was kind of that's good.
Vitruvius, Morgan Freeman's character coming back as a ghost on a string.
Right. And of course the best theme song ever in a movie. Everything is awesome. Yeah.
The perfectly catchy but annoying song.
Right. Yeah.
Which you're gonna hear
for a while now.
For a while now.
Yeah.
All right, so that's what we thought of the Lego Movie. Let us know what you thought. If you've seen it, how many times have you seen it?
Right.
Did you like it as much as we did? And do you think, is it more for kids or more for adults? Because I kind of sway more for adults, even though it's a kids' movie. You can post your comments below on the website, thinkhero.com, or on YouTube, Think Hero Pro. Make sure to subscribe to that.
If you want to come chat with Dennis or myself about the Lego Movie, let's talk about possibilities maybe for a sequel. Mm-hmm. This is definitely going to get a sequel,
yeah.
I'm sure. Let us know what you think about that at Think Hero. I'm at GriffinDE.
And we also have a Facebook page. That's facebook.com/thinkherofans. And make sure to like that page and share our videos on Twitter and Facebook and everything else.